conversation, that the scope and the meaning of force majeure clause in a commercial contracts, and how is it different from doctrine of frustration? So I would love to know your opinion on the same.
See, the first thing what anyone has to understand when reading this concept is that force majeure is solely a creation of contract. Unless you have a force majeure clause in your contract, you will not be able to get any benefit out of it. Now, what exactly is a force majeure event? A force majeure event is any event which makes the performance of the contract temporarily impossible or fundamentally different, radically different, or completely impossible without the fault of the either party. It has nothing to do with fault-based liability. If either of the parties is responsible for the event or the non-performance arising out of it, they cannot invoke the doctrine of force majeure. Sorry, the contractual remedy of force majeure. Now, force majeure can lead to temporary suspension of contract as well as completely ending the contract. It depends on the circumstances. I'll give you an example. For instance, there is a strike planned by a labor group for 1 month in a mining contract, which is for 30 years. While it may qualify for the force majeure event, the mining company can write to the government saying that for these 30 days, we will not be able to extract any coal. And therefore, this event would qualify as a force majeure event because, see, it's not my fault that the strike is happening. It's not government's fault that the strike is happening, but the strike is happening and it's covered under the contract. So therefore, this will be a force majeure event. But this will not be a frustrating event. This will only temporarily suspend the operation of the contract. This will not end the contract completely. That is the primary understanding of force majeure clause. Now, see, it's a contractual remedy. It arrived from the Roman law and French law, force majeure itself. But it finds its legitimacy in India under Section 32 of ICA, which says that when a certain events become impossible after the contract has been executed. But however, it's a contractual remedy. The parties are free to decide what will constitute a force majeure event, what will not constitute a force majeure event, how to invoke a force majeure clause. For instance, in almost all the contracts right now, when a strike happens, for example, or when the permission for the land acquisition permission is struck down by the court, the party which is performing the contract has to inform the other party within certain period of coming of know of the force majeure event. So the procedural requirements under the contract will also have to be met. So the force majeure itself is a completely contractually dependent remedy. If you don't have a force majeure clause in the contract, you cannot invoke it. If you don't follow the procedure envisaged under the contract in commercial contracts for this force majeure, you cannot invoke it at all. Then moving to frustration. Now, frustration is a completely common law remedy. It doesn't matter whether you have a clause in the contract or not. Frustration will survive. It's a completely law-based remedy. It comes under Section 56 of Indian Contract Act. It's a subset of force majeure in the sense when force majeure event, I'm not talking about the clause, I'm talking about the force majeure event, the underlying event that renders the performance impossible or difficult or temporarily suspended. When the performance is completely impossible, then the contract cannot be performed no matter what happens. In the manner it was envisaged under the contract, it becomes the doctrine of frustration. So what force majeure does, it allows you to temporarily suspend or end the contract. Frustration only ends the contract. The day frustrating event happens and you notify, all further obligations are discharged. Neither party is under any obligation to perform the agreement whatsoever. It ends. The contract is killed in simple words. Secondly, and one of the most important things, it does not depend on the conduct of the parties. Now, what happens in force majeure? There is a force majeure event. The contract has become impossible to perform, but you did not notify the other party. So while the force majeure event happened, you will not be able to take benefit because you failed to comply with the procedural requirement. Therefore, the conduct of parties is relevant in terms of the contract. In case of frustration, it does not matter. the moment frustrating event happens, your contract is over. You notify the other side, your contract is over, you are done and dusted. All the obligations that have arisen prior to the frustration will have to be completed. But all the obligations which were to be performed post the frustrating event will not have to be done. I'll give you an example. What exactly would be a frustration and what would be a force majeure event? So let's take example of a 99-year lease. Not lease, 99-year contract for supply of 50 vehicles every month. Now for this COVID period, for example, the factories were shut down, the exports were shut down, everything was shut down because of government guidelines. So this would amount to a force majeure event for the period of lockdown. Right? It will temporarily suspend the contract. But will it frustrate the contract? Does it mean that for entire 99 years now you cannot supply the vehicles? No. That is the difference. Frustration has to mean that the contract cannot be performed at all in the manner it was supposed to be. Now I'll give you an example of a contract which is frustrated. In these industries which are highly leveraged and highly institutionalized, force majeure clauses are present. And most of the parties involved in these transactions do not want these companies to fall. So they generally agree to a post force majeure event application of force majeure clause. Also, they add a clause if they haven't. The biggest setback of this entire, of the biggest problem you'll face will be the MSME industries, the small industries, which generally use the templates given by their associations or given by the Vyapari Sanghs, which have a very boilerplate clause of two words saying that this will constitute force majeure and this will not constitute, or they don't even talk about the procedure or what, they have an exhaustive definition. So the biggest problem that will arise in this case when they cannot invoke a force majeure clause will happen in the MSME sector and not in the highly corporatized or institutionalized sectors.
Right.
Now I'll just, on this point, I'll give you an example of, since you brought the airways, I had noted an example of what exactly would be a frustrating event. For instance, if I enter into a contract with you for delivery of a specific helicopter manufactured by Bell with a specific number, let's say VT-101. Now that helicopter got caught in a cyclone and got destroyed while coming from Dubai. Now that helicopter is gone. It's not available. While I can have a replacement helicopter, I can give you a replacement helicopter. But it will not be the helicopter we contracted for because it was a specific helicopter with a specific number and a specific make. Therefore, the contract cannot be performed in the manner we agreed and therefore it is frustrated.
Right, sir.
I'll give you another example. For instance, when you come to cultivation of peppermint, it requires a certain kind of land and the cultivators generally prefer a land which is near to a river. Now, I contracted with you to get my peppermint supply from a specific field which is next to a specific river because the quality is good. Now tomorrow a flood comes and the entire field gets destroyed. The contract will be frustrated. You cannot give me an alternate supply from somewhere else. The contract's performance has become impossible. However, if I just contract for instance, say coal from you, that I want to buy 50 tons of coal from you. You had in your mind planned that I will get my coal from Indonesia. And that coal supply suddenly stopped because Indonesian government said, no, we will not supply coal to India due to some international dispute. That will not amount to frustration. Because I never asked you to get me coal specifically from Indonesia. Just because the obligation on you, now you have to buy the coal in India, which is much more costly. Just because the financial cost has increased, does not mean that the contract is frustrated. It has to be radically and commercially impossible, not merely onerous. Merely financial difficulty will not get you out of the contract. Only financial impossibility will.
Right, sir.
This is right.